What's up, everybody? Doug here with Leaving the Dream. This is video number 5 in a series of videos that I'm doing that outline and discuss the facts as laid out by the 7 people who've turned government witness against Mike Miskey and Miskey Enterprise. I'm going to do it in the order in which they made these plea agreements. This will make it easier for me to catalog. This video in particular is about one Ashlyn Akau. She's the 6th person to agree to testify against Miskey and the others. If you missed the first video on Joan Ortiz, you can just click right here. I also want to say mahalo to Ian Lind for his article, which I used as the source of my information for this video. The link to that article can be found in the description below so that you can read it for yourself. Let's get into it. So number 6, Ashlyn Akau. She is facing life in prison for charges related to her involvement in the chemical weapons attack carried out in 2017. In court documents, Ashlyn Akau admitted to participating in a chemical attack on Ginza nightclub using chloropicrin on March 5th, 2017. Akau said that prior to the attacks, she had been recruited by Norman Akau and Jake Smith to assist them in robbing several drug dealers. It's because of that experience with them that Smith felt comfortable enough to recruit her to help with this particular chemical attack. Ashlyn told investigators that she was told by Smith that Mike Miskey was paying him $3,000 for this chemical attack on the nightclub, but that if she helped him, Smith would pay her $1,500 and basically split the money with her. Smith told her that they needed a girl to do it because Kalana Freitas had just done the same attack the night before and the boys were getting stopped at the door, probably by security. Smith told Ashlyn that Mike wanted to attack Ginza so that everyone would go to his nightclub instead. Ashlyn said that Smith picked her up from her house, then they drove together to John Stansel's house. John is Mike Miskey's half-brother. Jake then went inside Stansel's house for about 15 minutes while she waited in the car. And when Smith returned to the car, he was carrying bottles inside of cups so that his skin wasn't touching the bottles. Smith then drove Ashlyn to the scene and they waited for like 3 hours in the car. Ashlyn said that Smith then got a call from Mike Miskey. She also said that based on what she could hear of the conversation in the car, Mike wanted them to wait until the club was as crowded as possible to carry out the chemical attack. Ashlyn said that at a certain point, Mike Miskey pulled up in his own car and that Jake Smith got out of the car that they were in and got into Mike's car. They drove around for like 15 minutes somewhere. And when they came back, Jake told her that Mike just wanted to make sure that she was okay and everything was going to go as planned. Ashlyn said that when she got into the club without any problems, she had one of the bottles of chemicals and she poured it onto the dance floor. She said that customers began to scramble for the exits. That's when her eyes became irritated, she started coughing really bad, and then her hands got really burned from the chemicals. Ashlyn Akau was charged with chemical weapons attacks on March 18th, 2021. She's currently free on $25,000 unsecured bond and is facing life in prison and a $250,000 fine. In my next video, I'll be discussing Hunter Wilson, who is the 7th person to turn government witness against Mike Miskey and his enterprises. For that video, you can just click right here. If you haven't watched my original video on Mike Miskey and his enterprises, you can just click on this video right here to get caught up. Thank you guys for watching. I do appreciate the support, and until the next time, aloha.